48.
Exactly what the game needs. I'm an entertainer. I'm always conscious of the man in the street who pays a fiver, and that man wants to see fast play. Yeah. If I can help someone escape the dreary working class environment, then that's not a bad thing, is it? Oh. You just get my name right in the papers. It's Alexander the Great.
I thought we agreed on Hurricane. Hurricane Higgins.
Excuse me, Mr. Higgins. Mr. Higgins, it's just we do have a dress code.
I know you do, Ted, and I'd love to wear it, but I can't do the tie on account of my neck disease. You do know I have a neck disease, don't you? It's the same one as afflicts of violinists. I have a doctor's note. Come on in, you can read it for yourself.
Mr. Higgins, I must ask you not to urinate in the sink.
Forgive me, Ted. I'd introduce you, but I don't know their names.
Two girls straight off the streets of Birmingham. He's banned.
I was wondering if you might provide me with some information about the tables and the facilities in this establishment. You know what the pockets are like and the and the slate.
Do you need me to call your mum?
What about the nap?
Alex Higgins. Hurricane Higgins. A snooker player?
What snooker? Excuse me.
Please, Claire, what's your name?
doing?
Oh, I don't know. He's been at it about an hour.
Is this a lad?
Yeah.
God, he's pale, isn't he? I bet he gets sunburnt when he opens the fridge. He's thin and all. I've seen more meat on Linda McCartney's fork. Don't say much, does he? He's like Marcel Marceau in a library. Parlez-vous the English, senorita?
Sorry, Mr. Hearn. I did find your jokes very funny, but I like to concentrate when I'm practising.
Do you want a drink, Davis? It is Steve Davis, isn't it?
Yes. Yes, it is, Mr. Hearn. That's very kind. Milk, please. Cold milk is fine.
Well, you don't drink.
I like an eggnog. You know, at Christmas and... No, actually, I don't like it.
What do you do then, apart from snooker? Smoke? Gamble? Drugs? Girls? Boys? Inflatable dolls?
I play mental chess.
Is it any good?
I don't know, boss. I can't play mental chess.
No, at snooker, you wally.
Oh, yeah. It'd be anyone who walks in that door.
Lynn! 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 I tried phoning.
I know. 20 times.
I'm not great with the phone. I thought I'd charm you in person. Look, I'm sorry about the other night. I'm not really like that.
Really? That's not what I've heard.
I'm sometimes like that, but I can tell you deserve better. Let me take you out, Bev. What's the worst that can happen?
Now, the trick is to keep the bottom one still and get the top one to pinch the food together. Like this. Fuck's sake. I don't think these are proper chopsticks. That's me. Winning my first tournament.
Yeah.
I know. I haven't changed a bit.
Sandy, that's a girl's name.
That's what my big sisters call me.
They look like they can keep you out of trouble.
I wish. No, I'm always on the road.
Oh, don't tell me. Hurricane Higgins gets lonely.
It's not all razzmatazz, Lynn. I can be playing in front of 1,000 people, all the people at home watching on the telly. But I'm a snooker player. In the end, you're always on your own.
Hmm. Your mates were right. Hurricane Higgins is a right flash bastard. But like Alex Higgins. Come on.
Where are we going?
Deserts of Sudan and the gardens of Japan, from Milan to Yucatan. Every woman.
Here he is, the man of the moment, the hurricane in Romford. Get this man a drink.
Thanks for coming down, Alex. I really appreciate
it. Lager.
It'll do wonders for the kid. I mean, he's good, but he's green, you know, especially in front of the top players like yourself.
You know, Baz, it's going to be awful difficult for me to play snooker with your head in my jacksie.
Noted, noted. Here he is.
Davis? Davis?
What happened? Did a carrot fuck a snail up the arse?
Yes!
You know, Baz, I'm sorry, but I can't keep my eyes open. What'd you say? We make this interesting.
You say so, Alex.
Looks like I found my game, but lost my hearing.
Sorry, Barry, that's a lot of money.
Don't you worry, you're not gonna lose, okay? Go on, my son. Come on.
You owe me 40, Cyril, all right? Cheers. Well done. We'll have a drink later to celebrate that.
So what do you think of the lad?
I don't. I'd have killed him in a proper match without this bunch of hooligans and me. This place is a fucking disgrace. That top cushion's got more bounce than a pair of page three tits.
Thanks for coming, Alex.
Get that man a pint of milk and make it gold top. Taxi for the hurricane.
I've been waiting a long time to meet a man like you, Davis. I bet that's something you don't hear very often. You see, I think snooker is going to be big. Properly big. Bigger even than wrestling. I'm being serious. And I want us to go into partnership together. We can be like Giant A Stacks and Big Daddy.
Do you mean like, what, 50-50?
Jesus, Davis, I was only gonna take 10. I think you better let me do the haggling from now on. Look, you just pot the balls and I'll take care of everything else.
Everything what else?
I'm gonna make you and me very, very rich. How's that sound? Jesus, Dave, it's just like strangling a lettuce. Come here, you big nugget. I hope that's your snooker cue.
That's it. That's what the grannies like to see. A nice, clean-cut, well-dressed young man. Bending over a table.
Barry.
Come on, princess, give us a 12. Show us what you got back there. No, something's not right. Spiros. Can you try him a different pair of socks, please?
It's about 9 o'clock, in fact. People have been queuing outside, and the queues were stretching way down the street, and it's a very busy scene inside the Crucible. And it's that, I think, because all the 9 players who are left in this championship are all playing matches today, and this is very important. Please take a look at the lineup of the championship as it stands at the moment.
Jesus, Bill, did you not get those Jane Fonda videos I sent?
Kiss my ass.
Come on, James. I'll introduce you. Kirk Stevens, lock up your daughters. Tony Knowles, lock up your wife. Hey? Oh, Cliff Thorburn, lock up your mom. Oh, and Dennis Taylor, lock up your granny. This is Jimmy White, the whirlwind amateur world champion who, one day, when I've retired, will be the embassy world champion.
What, you got a cigar for?
He doesn't look old enough to buy cigarettes.
No, I just become a dad.
Yes, babe. Jesus. What did Barry do to you? You look like an undertaker. No, you don't. He looks like the cadaver.
I was told that they had asteroids in here.
Oh, asteroids? Isn't that what you had, Dennis? Didn't they give you a cream for it? I'll have a pint. Jimmy, what do you want?
Then the big match. Alex Higgins, 72 champion, against Steve Davis, the new sensation of the snooker world.
Quickest potter on the planet. Please welcome to the Crucible, Alex Hurricane Higgins!
We're not in Rome for now.
Championship quarterfinal from London. Please welcome Steve
Davis. All right, son. Well, Steve Davis had to go there, and I am afraid it's going to be very costly for him. Has upset Steve.
A terrific performance by Alex Higgins.
Arrogant and box office snooker by Alex Higgins.
Absolutely brilliant. Alex is such a talented player.
Last time's the world trophy. That together with £15,000.
May the best man win.
Awful gracious of you, Grinder, but at least let's go through the motions.
So please put your hands together for Cliff Thorburn. And looking to win his second world crown from Northern Ireland, please welcome Alex Hurricane Higgins.
So Alex goes into the lead in a very favourable position indeed.
That's kamikaze snooker.
I know. Magic, innit?
That was a leap of the ball.
What are you take that on for? What does he think this is? Mission Impossible? Boom, 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 boom. This snooker player will self-destruct in 5 minutes.
And Alex watching every stroke, surely seeing the world title run away from him. He just wants this frame to become world snooker champion. That shot must truly sadden the
heart. Alex Hurricane Higgins.
He blew it.
Playing to the gallery like there's an audience award for the best shot. You can't take a round of applause to the bank. He's like a little boy lost. He's desperate for approval. Emotion, Davis, is the enemy of success.
OK, boss.
Good. But we can do better. We need to create an aura of invincibility around you. Right, bear with me, Davis. I want you to sit up on that seat like you're on a kamikaze doing your business. Come on. That's how you should sit when you're in tournaments, right? Cross your legs a little bit.
What, have I finished on the kamikaze now?
Yeah. Yeah, look. You're there, all right? You're at the crucible, yeah? Picture it. Last frame, okay? Everybody's waiting for you to make your shot. OK? You're thinking it through, thinking it through. Open your eyes. I want you to feel like you've seen a lot of trauma, but I don't want to see your thoughts. I want to see nothing. Just eyes. Dead. That's my boy. Good. OK. Need something else.
Need a drink.
No. Look, it's not a cup of warm milk before bedtime. It's a weapon. No, don't gulp it. Just sip it. No, don't sip it either.
But what else is there?
OK. Just pick it up, put it to your lips, and then put it back down again.
Why?
I don't know. But it's terrifying.
But, won't the other players just think I'm a Wally?
No, Davis, they won't. They'll think you're a total arsehole. And that is what we want. Think of it as mental snooker.
No, it was luck, Thorburn. That's what it was. You got lucky today. That referee's always hating me. They all hate me. You fucking cheat. Alex. Don't you fucking hang up on me!
Alex, what are you doing? Alex, stop it! Alex! Alex, listen to me. Listen, it's all right. Alex, listen, it's all right. Alex, listen to me. Listen. Listen, there's always next year, okay? It's all right.
Steve Davis, making his debut in a big-time championship. The first time he's appeared in a final, is about to don the crown of UK champion.
Commonplace in sport, but Steve Davis commands that.
I mean, he's become a feared player. It is more a game of pressure.
There's no way that anyone could stop him.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome world number one and Romford's own Steve Davis. And his opponent this afternoon is the Croydon Echo letter writing competition winner. He's a smashing kid with the highest break of 16. Please welcome Matthew Harrison.
Hello, nice to meet you.
Would you like to call for me, please?
Heads.
Is a head Matthew Harrison to break?
Go on, Matthew!
Good break. Well done. Well done. Very good.
One. Eight. 56. 102. 134 on the frame, Steve Davis.
There is no one around who can concentrate for long enough to be a threat to my dominating major tournaments for years to come.
Very good morning. Yes, it is a little early, but believe it or not, they are already playing snooker here on this Monday of the Embassy World Professional Championships in Sheffield. No doubt we were talking about the pressure shots and the tension. Psychological battles, which have always been evident behind the scenes in this world championship, have begun again.
Bye, Angel Fish. Right, touch my cue for luck. There you go. Daddy's got to go to work. Bye.
Good luck.
All right.
Alex?
Fuck off.
Steve?
Oh, I don't know if you heard, but I just had a little girl. Lauren, her name is.
I was at the birth. Now, I'll be honest with you. It was the most disgusting thing I've ever seen. Blood everywhere. I mean, the doctors, they warned me what happens to business end during birth. But I said I'd be all right. I'd cope. Because I knew Steve Davis.
Steve
Davis. He's the world's biggest
cunt. Come on, my son. Go on, Steve.
Give me a vodka.
That was beautiful.
What'll it be, Steve? What'd you say, Barry? Is he allowed to stop and have a drink, or is he too good for us?
Too good for you? Come on, Alex, give me a challenge.
Come on, you ginger twat. You can't play Space Invaders all the time.
Come on, I'll buy you a drink.
No, you won't. You'll buy me two fucking drinks.
All right, done. Two halves it is.
Honestly, Barry, he's no good for the game. You've gone and built a robot. Who's going to want to watch that when you can see a flair player?
A flair player? That's hilarious. That just means you miss.
Well, at least I miss with style.
Disgraceful goddamn sight I've ever seen in snooker. I've known this piece of shit for a decade, right, Bill?
Up high.
I just hope they spell his name right on the trophy. B-A-R-R-Y. Maybe get a pistol on your little finger. Maybe get a blister on your thumb. We got to install my parameters.
$10,000. That's right, for the week. No, Hamish, that's not lira, that's pound sterling. You listen to me. You want Ferrari, don't pay Ford prices. OK, you come back to me, but don't leave it too long. Everybody wants a piece of Davis, and that price is only going to go up. Davis, I want you to meet Brian. He's going to write us your autobiography.
But I'm only 23.
It doesn't matter. He's going to pad it out, loads of diagrams. That way, even Jimmy White can read it.
Harry, shouldn't I write my autobiography?
Davis, don't be a wally. Even your biggest fan's not going to want to wade through an entire chapter on how to chalk a cue. Besides, you're going to need that magic to write your column in the Star. Here, Brian, they love him at the Star. Look at that. You could have flexed your muscles.
I did.
Hold on. Hamish, I betcha. Barry Earn? Good man, Hamish. Right, so, $11,000 for the week, then. Yeah, I know I said 10, but that was 2 minutes ago. I told you, you got to be quick. Go on, then. Who is it? Well, in that case, you better make it 12 and a half.
You all right, Davis?
No, no, I'm not. There is only one word to describe Alex Higgins. Obnoxious.
Oh, I think there's a few more than that, but that's the one that Brian will put in the autobiography.
All right, but if he touches me again, then I'm not responsible for what I might do.
Well, what will you do?
Probably go home.
All right, I'll sort it.
Steve Davis, 58.
Stamina is one aspect of the game that is all too commonly forgotten. Just because snooker players don't chase a football, it doesn't mean that we don't need to be in a prime physical condition. As I was saying...
Jesus, Brian. It's been a week. We're not finished yet. Steve Davis is boring. The end.
Alex, I thought we had an agreement.
God's sake. One, two, three.
Thank you.
You know, I thought it was the idea of Steve Davis I used to hate. But now I've got to know you a little better. I actually had Steve Davis the man even more.
Yeah, well, you're drunk.
Yes, I am. But in the morning, I shall be sober, and you
will still be boring. Alex, it is the morning.
Shh. Right then, Davis, you're set.
I don't suppose you've room in the car for one more.
I'll do as it happens. Brian, snap to it.
You know, I can't drive myself. Don't be like that.
I think there's something you need to talk to your own manager about, Alex. Whoever that currently is.
I intend to.
Room number, sir?
I'm not staying here. I can't afford to.
Right.
Let me see that.
Well, that's very generous of you, Alex. Thank you.
Well, you must have got a good deal for Davis. But just imagine what I earned for this trip.
I don't have to. I know. $2,000. I got more than that. Thank you. Most enjoyable.
Thank you.
Bye. Well, I wouldn't sign for you, even if you asked me.
Well, that's good, because I'm not asking.
Pride, Barry. It's a terrible thing. You'd snap my hand off.
Where is he? Where's Beadle?
I don't need anyone to hold my hand and put my suitcase in the car, but I know you're a bit of a whiz on the old pocket calculator.
Wait a minute. Are you asking me? No chance.
I'll always be the biggest draw in the game. So fuck you and fuck Davis.
You see, it's that attitude that has no place in what I'm trying to build here, with an ethos of impeccable professionalism.
Fuck you, I don't want to join.
And politeness at all times. How am I supposed to market someone as rude as you to IBM?
That is a disgraceful slur on my character, Barry. And fuck IBM. Their computers are shite. What's that got to do with snooker?
The world's changing, Alex. My new matchroom stable recognizes that.
My new matchroom stable recognizes. Well, I'm not changing, and I'd certainly never change for you. You know what the people want? Me! This is the box office!
Steve Davis, the living embodiment of snooker perfection. This black for the first televised 147.
It was John Spencer back in 1979. It was only not televised because you pricks took a tea break. For fuck's sake, Ted. You got a hard-on for Davis or what?
He's done it. Steve Davis engraves his name on history with a break of faultless brilliance. We are surely watching the greatest player that has ever graced the bays.
You're up early.
Haven't been to bed.
What have you been doing, love?
Really?
By the 1981 World Championship, Alex's decline is being noticed for the first
Alex,
time.
Alex, I think we really need to stop talking about Steve Davis.
Where is it? Oh, here it is. Alex can no longer achieve what he used to attain. He's fucking obsessed with me.
Listen, it doesn't matter, okay?
He's obsessed with me.
Doesn't matter. Obsessed. No matter what happens, you've always got me and you've always got Lauren.
You're right. I'll hunt that bastard till they carry me out in the little brown box.
Sweetheart, I really think we need to try and get you some help.
Oh, baby. Please, just don't. James, you just give me the names of the bastards that did this to you, and I swear to God...
Oh, it's my new management. They puffed me out. I said no, but...
Not Barry Hearn.
Nah, wouldn't join that mob.
So, what happened? You had a fight and got your teeth knocked in?
And I reckon it'd be good for sponsorship and that. It's all about image there, isn't it?
Who else do they manage? Spandau Ballet?
Nah. Barry Manilow. You heard Tony Mia signed for Earn. He's one of the Metron boys now.
He's taken the fucking spick.
Yeah, he's been told to clean up his act. No more disco dancing. It's like being back at school.
How would you know?
He's got Terry and all. It's all changing, Alex.
Well, good luck to them. They'll need it.
Anyway, I bought you some grapes.
Good lad, Beth.
You sure this is in hospital?
They've even got a snooker table in the games room.
Oh, yeah?
Mm.
Been hustling all the nutcases, have you?
No. I don't feel like playing.
So what happened then? You ain't gonzo, lose your marbles.
It's called exhaustion, James. You know, I just needed a rest.
So we're not gonna see you in Sheffield, then?
Doesn't matter. Davis is going to win anywhere.
Anybody take the title away from the man who's become one of the biggest names, not just in snooker, but in all sport, Steve Davis. What a remarkable time he's had over a couple of years. He came here, he won the title last year. Since then, he's done everything right. And the bookmaker made him 5-2 on favourite to retain the title. And nobody has ever retained the World Professional Snooker Championship title here in the Crucible.
$3,000, Alex Higgins to be snooker champion of the world. What's going on?
As long as he knocks out a nugget, mate.
Oh my God. Mm. It's like your robot's broken down, Barry. Can I write this chapter in your next autobiography?
Come on, you done. Good boy. See you later, fellas.
Thank you. Time, gentlemen, please.
Davis has come to win anyway.
Please welcome Jimmy Rowerwind White.
Easy. Can you get the feeling, Jack, this could be the winning break?
And Alex finding it hard to bear, I think, at the moment. So Alex breathes again. 59 points in front now. And still enough points on the table for Alex, if he can just take his opportunity. He has to win this frame to stay in the match. And if he does win it, what an electric finish it's going to be.
That shot has brought the only red that was relatively safe over the centre pocket. Well, he can pot this blackjack, and I think he's got to go for it. This is the big shot of the frame. And the tremendous shot under pressure. A lot of courage Alex has got. Now another difficult red into the centre pocket.
And Alex not able to afford any mistakes.
Right hand corner. And then another tremendous shot.
Oh, and that's a beautiful shot.
I tend to think, Jack, this has become a test of courage.
And Alex really rising to the occasion here. This really is something.
I'm feeling nervous for him, Jack. I think if he clears this, this would be the break of the tournament.
62. And what a fabulous break if he knocks this black in. Go mad. 15 frames all. What a finish. So Jimmy Watt concedes. What a splendid finish. And a truly, truly superb semi-final. So the people's player now has a chance to really be the people's champion.
I love you, baby. From the first moment I held you in my arms. And now, your daddy is playing in the final tomorrow. It's gonna change everything. I'm gonna prove all those bastards wrong. I promise you, baby. I won't ever let you down.
Congratulations to every side for this extraordinary young Irishman who has done so much for the world of snooker since he came on the scene just 10 years ago.
Now she's in me. Always with me. Tiny gifts in my hand. Jesus reigns out in the street, and them tickets are gone.
Look at anyone.
Turn him back. She just laughs. The boulevard is not that bad.
Hey. I want a baby. Let me take my baby. I gotcha.
The man who said, I want so much to become the people's champion, has won the championship the people have watched and applauded.
Champion, but more importantly, out there, you know, I'm the people's champion. In the words of Frank Sinatra, I did it my way. Jimmy says you're in the music business.
I fucking told you this is UB40s.
I know, you don't have to tell me that again. I'm your biggest fan. Paddy, I'm as fucked off as you. But, you know, we've got a flat tire. And, what else can go wrong in a car?
The radiator.
And the radiator's fallen off. We'll be there on Tuesday. Is it? Wednesday then, tomorrow? Yep, tomorrow. I'll buy you a pint. Okay, ciao, bye.
So what did Paddy say?
He said we've got time to go to the races.
In 3, 2.
Hello. Welcome to a
Friday. Wait for the music, Steve.
Hello, welcome to a frame.
Camera 2.
Oh, right, here.
Camera two, yes.
This is the one, yes, one with the light on, Steve. So you've got to look at the camera with the light on.
Right. Yeah, I see.
It looks great. You look beautiful. It looks good, honestly, mate.
OK. All right. Sorry.
Don't worry about it. It's what a screen test for. Just take your time.
Oh, OK. Yeah. Hello. Welcome to A Frame with Davis. Today, I've got two guest celebrities who are going to have a game of snooker against each other.
Yeah, yeah, Steve, that's great. But we know you can play snooker. The idea is to interview the guests at the same time.
Sorry, Miles, was I in the zone again?
No, Steve, you're doing great, OK? Just ask me a question. Fire away.
OK. So, Bernie Winters, when did you first realise that you wanted to be in the show business?
I'll tell you what, can we just cut then? Can we just take five, Miles? Is that all right with you?
Yes.
OK.
Oh, sorry, Barry, this just isn't really me, is it?
Granted. But then that's not really you either, is it? No, when you're playing. That's more like tournament, Steve. You see, what we're after here is a sort of third Steve. A personality, Steve.
But I'm boring.
I know you are. We just need to make you boring in a really fun way. You know, get you to tell a few jokes.
Don't know any jokes.
Which is good. You'll have the element of surprise on your side. Right, look. Have a look at this. And a few notes. Have a read of some of them, all right?
I'm so boring, my nickname is Steve Davis.
That's the one. Now go.
I'm so boring, my nickname is Steve Davis.
So I didn't realise you were doing it then. OK, all right, look, we'll do it once more, OK? Right, this time, what we'll do, the shake and vac and put the freshness back, all right? Watch this. I'm so boring, my nickname's Steve Davis. I think Robbo likes it. Well, why aren't you laughing?
Sorry, I've heard it before.
Fellas, you're 4 hours late. They're baying for blood in there. Where have you been?
Glad, Paddy, they love me. I'm the people's champion. And ladies and gentlemen, please welcome him back to Ireland. World champion Alex Higgins.
It's good to be wise when you're young.
Someone's nicked it.
All the money's in there. I got my fucking trophy!
Fucking hell. I stole a new B40.
Fuck's sake!
Why don't you know when you'll be back?
Depends how many exhibition matches Jimmy's lined up.
We need you here.
We need the money, in case you hadn't noticed. Look, love, I'm trying to do everything I can for this family. It's not my fault Ireland was such a disaster that my single didn't make it into the charts. I mean, it's hard enough as it is at the moment.
It's hard for me too, you know.
Would it kill you to be just a little bit supportive?
Alex, I'm pregnant. I can't do everything by myself.
Well, I'm world champion. I can do anything I like.
Pardon?
Look, love, it'll just be a couple of days. No more than a week, I promise.
What about your snooker cue?
Fuck.
So don't you want another nipper then? Don't look happy about it.
Of course I am, it's just... I've just barely lost a word from the last one.
Oh, go on, then. But I told Maureen I was only popping out to buy some milk.
Alex, please, language in front of my wife.
Sorry. Tell me, darling, see the grinder on and off the table, if you get my drift.
Alex, please, we're having an enjoyable evening. Damn it if we're gonna let you spoil it.
You are a Canadian cunt.
Alex, I've had about as much of you as I can take, so think very carefully about what you say next.
You fucking shit at snooker!
Would you excuse me, my dear?
I'm gonna fucking kick her out!
Fuck you!
Pound on you!
My fist! My sword!
Look out!
Right up your ass!
You just
hit
white.
All right, show's over!
It's all right, it's all right.
Jimmy, get him the hell out of here! You little streak of piss!
Messing around, huh? Calm down, Clef. All right? All right? You're just messing around? Come on. Okay, come on. All right? I'm sorry, love.
Right, fine.
Still fucking mented.
Oh, fuck you!
Jesus Christ! Come on, honestly.
Little shit stain.
Oh, no, yeah. We do have a laugh. Yeah, when I got asked to come and do the show, I said, you do know I'm boring, don't you? And they said, how boring? I said, I'm so boring, my nickname is Steve Davis. I'm glad you find that one funny.
Go on, my son.
My shot, is it?
A very good morning to you. And if you were planning anything else today, well, I would cancel it. Because I think we're in store here for the most interesting day yet in the 1983 Embassy Professional Snooker Championship of the World. Right then, the start of day 14. Alex Higgins and Steve Davis. We will be with the semi-finals right throughout the day and through the evening.
Here they are. Cagney and fucking Lassie. You know, no one's ever won two in a row. Before now, that is.
I hope I win, Alex, for your sake. Someone's got to stop you celebrating the last one.
Since when does he make jokes?
Since he got his own chair shot.
Number one, Steve Davis.
You too, but I can't come home. I'm playing an exhibition match.
So this exhibition match, who are you playing?
Jimmy. I'll be there in a minute. Just give me a minute, Jimmy.
Higgins, you pig. Have you finished with these?
Who was that?
Nobody.
I'm not nobody. I'm Oliver fucking Reed.
And Ollie Reed is here as well.
Oh, shut
up. Is Higgins score? Liam? Oh, fuck. Liam, just calm down. Tell me, what have I done?
Alex, you're never at home.
I'm at home now.
Listen, it's worse when you are at home.
See, there you go. I can't win.
Look, I don't want our kids to see you pissed all the time.
So I like a drop of a drink if that's the worst of our problems.
Alex, I am worried that I'm going to end up getting AIDS.
Liam, I swear on my life, I'm not into fellas.
Alex, you are not listening to me.
Look, I know, all right, I'm not a model husband, okay? I admit that, but I love you. All right, if you want me to change, I'll change.
Noah, listen, I want you to, I really do, but you will never change.
I'll never give up on my family. The hurricane never gives up. Come home, then.
I can't do it. I'm sorry.
Come.
Alex, I said no.
Come on, mate, you can sort this. My mooring gets like this. A bit antsy. When she calms down and, you know, we just carry on like it never happened. Until the next time. That's what marriage is.
Come on, follow me. I'll give you the tour. Kitchen. Portable colour TV. Dishwasher. Microwave. All you have to do all day is just sit around and push buttons.
Do you really think this is going to solve all of our problems?
I know, we'll get an au pair, but you have to admit, it's a good place for a fresh start.
Alex, how many fresh starts can I give you?
I know. I know it's my final last chance, but you know, the hurricane's never better than when his back's against the wall.
It's too big. I'd be lonely when you're not here.
Oh, and the pièce de résistance. My snooker
room.
I can practice here. No more going away for days on end. And I'm getting a new manager.
I don't know.
You don't know? What? You don't think we can afford it? We can. Snooker's never been bigger, and I'm back to my best.
I mean, I don't know if I'm ready, Alex.
I'll win 60 grand for the embassy next year. I'll build us a swimming pool.
You can't even swim.
For you and the kids. Imagine little Lauren and Jordan playing out there, raising hell. Be like a real family again. I know that's what you want, really. Please say yes, because the truth is, I've already bought it.
It's Monopoly meets Kaplunk.
You think people are going to actually buy this?
Of course they will. Especially when I throw in a pair of these.
What have they got to do with snooker?
Nothing. That's the genius bit.
That phone is red hot. It will not stop ringing.
Busby's working overtime, and I think I need a new fax machine. Barry Earn. No, I do not know if the world champion drinks coffee. Well, how much are we talking? He loves his stuff. He can't get enough of it. Especially, what brand you say it was again? Thank you very much.
Honestly, would you not rather have my face on an advert than that? Would you not say I'm a much sexier man?
Oh, yeah, much sexier.
Have you seen this one?
I don't read women's realm.
If I had to choose between sex and snooker, I'd choose snooker. So would she. Can you imagine that in bed? Spend 3 minutes walking round her, lining up the fucking shot. Probably chalks his bell end.
He did win Rear of the Year.
What the fuck are you talking about?
When it was Sue Pollard. Listen, Alex, I can get you deals. Just got Tony Knowles in with Vidal Sassoon.
Right.
Well, Tony can walk into any Vidal Sassoon salon anywhere in the country and get himself a free haircut.
I'm talking about getting me a TV advert, not a free fucking haircut. Do you have any idea how much this place costs me? I pay you 10% and you just draw a blank. A blankety blank. Why can't you even get me on blankety fucking blank?
People like winners.
Alex, darling, can I get some money? Because Katerina wants to take Lauren into town.
How am I meant to practice with all these constant interruptions? Are you sure this is a snooker tournament?
This place is bigger than your ass.
Don't mention that money, Pip. I'd have to win this just to pay the gas bill.
Yes, that's
right. What the fuck are you doing?
It's the Goya mushroom scent.
It's the international fragrance for men who play to win.
You want to be a winner? You've got to smell like a winner.
It's a mix of fir needles, tarragon, pimento, nutmeg, patchouli, musk, sandalwood, and tonka beans.
Hey, Grinder, what's all this shit?
Beats me. Thought we were here to play goddamn snooker.
I may be the people's champion, not these fucking people.
Fucking Romford lot. It's all just fake, isn't it?
Barry, Barry, can you get us a pint of that, Goya matchroom?
I think you've had enough, Alex, don't you?
Fuck you, Barry. You don't tell me what to do. Jesus, they take it all so seriously now. Who is it that made all this possible? Got millions to watch, so Davis could line his fucking pockets.
Very own.
Me? The Hurricane. Before me, it was just old farts taking it in turns to miss. Barry, can we open the window? Fucking stinks in here.
I'll tell you what, Alex, I'll open the door and you can walk straight out of it.
Are you offering me out, Barry? I'll fucking come outside with you. Just
Alex,
give me a
fucking... Alex,
I'll fucking
Alex,
kill you!
Just have a drink. Just have a drink. Come on.
What are you talking
listen,
about,
listen to me, listen. Play the game, mate. You've just got to play snooker and take his money, yeah?
Yeah, that's all he cares about. Fuck all this shit. Get out of my way! This is my bandwagon. You know that, Tintin, all right? You'll take more than perfume and fancy fucking canapes. Kick me off. What do you think, Willie? It's a bit of a fucking posh party, isn't it? Bit of a posh party. All right, Beb. I'm off now. One last one for the photographers. There you go. Get that in your fucking hands.
In every dream.
Fucking prick. Give me that. Give me fucking that. Fucking prick.
And every step I take takes me further from heaven. Is there a heaven? I'd like to think so. Standards of living. They're rising daily.
So this is how you practice?
I didn't know you were up.
But
just showing her some shots with my new cue. What do you expect,
it's only a saying.
I have a red-blooded male!
Oh, we'll be gone soon enough and you can fuck her whenever you want today!
Yeah, well, maybe I fucking will!
Mistake. I'm taking the kids and going to my parents and for good this time!
You can't fucking do that! Those children need a daddy!
Yes, you're fucking right!
What, so now I'm not a good daddy? The fuck are you going?
I'm scared of you, Alex. So am I!
Do you have any idea what I have to do for this family? The shit I have to deal with?
To do that, off of me!
Come here! Come here, Liv! Don't you go in there! I swear to God, Liv, come out here! Come out here, Liv! Come out so we can talk about this like civilized people! You fucking bitch!
My mind.
Mr. Higgins, who is due to play later today at the Goya Matchroom snooker tournament, was taken to nearby Macclesfield Police Station.
Snooker loopy nuts are we, me and him and you and me. We'll show you what we can do with a load of balls and a snooker cue. Pot the race then, screw back for the yellow, green, brown, blue, pink and black. Snooker loopy nuts are we, we're all snooker loopy.
Bless you, boys.
Right, Jim.
It's great, isn't it? Look.
And as the res he puts to bed, he likes to sing along. And if I win, he says, but the queen, it can only help me con it. I'll celebrate and buy another egg. They're precious for me, Barnet. But oh, will he phone? His ears all gone and his mates all take the ride. His opponents sing, cover up his new country shining in my eyes. When the light shines down,
who is it?
It's me, it's Jimmy.
I come in then?
Yeah, mate.
Mm-hmm. Sorry. Come in.
Tried phoning.
There's a problem with the phone.
Lynn's still not come round then?
No. She's got a court ruling. If I try to see her or the kids, then they'll put me in prison.
I'm sorry, mate.
It's no one's fault. Have you, had a breakfast?
No, no, Tar. I can't stop.
Oh, come on, James.
Got a culprit.
I haven't seen you for days. Cheers.
Listen, I just wanted to be the one to tell you. I've signed.
Barry fucking Hearn?
Yeah. Yeah, Barry fucking Hearn. He says I can be the matron bad boy. I can still do whatever I want as long as I check with him first.
That's great, but that's the best decision you ever made.
Well, that's funny, because I thought you was going to punch me.
No, but I will if you turn into one of them matrim arseholes.
Nah, you know I won't.
Me and you, James. We're the only two that ever played for love.
I better go. Robbo's waiting outside.
You know, it's funny, I was thinking of going to see Barry myself. He called the other day.
No. No, definitely, you should.
Maybe.
All right, I'll see you, mate.
Yeah. Be lucky, baby.
Don't worry, Frank, he'll pay. I'll make him pay. I gotta go, Frank.
Come in.
Yeah, all right, Frank. Look, I gotta go. Yep, I do know what you mean. Okay, bye.
Alex, always a pleasure. What do you want?
I have a bone to pick with you, Baz. You have nicked Jimmy. I want my practice partner back.
Drinking partner?
Well, the amount we drink protects a lot of practice.
So you worried about Jimmy?
I'm a lot of things, Barry, but I don't hold a grudge. You were too proud to ask me in 82. I'm sure you had reasons, and you probably regret those now since I won the embassy that year, but I'm here to offer you a chance to put that right and sign the people's champion, so long as the terms of the contract are right for me.
Lean, square-jawed, his good looks and clean-cut behaviour have made Steve Davis the hero of Britain. This is what I'm building here, Alex. Courage Brewery have just bought Steve Davis for a year. An exclusive contract, £1 million. So, unless I accidentally have a lobotomy, I'm not going to risk it all on you, am I?
Snooker needs me, Barry. Do you think people tune in hoping to watch Davis play Tony Meo? I'm the box office, me.
I know.
You admit it, you bastard.
You're right. We need you. The millions out there, they don't tune in to watch the snooker. They watch for the soap opera. It's Dallas with balls. And you're JR and Bobby Ewing rolled into one. You're destroying yourself. And it's a fact of life that millions of people enjoy watching the process. So, yeah, snooker needs you. But I don't need you.
Barry, please. Please, I'm begging you. I need you to manage me. I can't manage on my own. And, you know, I said I'd never change. Well, I'll change. I'll do anything, Barry. I'm on my fucking knees here.
I can't, Alex.
I've lost everyone. And I've lost my house, all the money. Fucking Inland Revenue are after me, you know? I'll even give up the drink, Barry. I promise.
It wouldn't last a day, Alex. I'm sorry.
We could do this. You know, I could change and you're the only one that can help me. I've lost my family.
Alex, you're a mess. Look, look, where are you headed to? I'll get Robbo to give you a lift somewhere.
I've nowhere to go. It's...
Well, I'm sure you know the booze are open somewhere near it. Take it, Alex. Take care, Alex.
Alex Higgins, 20.
Alex Higgins concedes forthwith. Steve Jones has played exceptionally well. From 5-all, he won 5 frames in succession to win by 10 frames to 5.
I actually am O'Higgins my life. True story, right? I was getting beaten up by 3 blokes. And Alex walks around the corner and says, "That's probably enough now, lads."
Alex. Hey, Alex.
How many has he had now?
Maybe I should go down.
Nah, Jimmy. Leave him. He won't thank you.
Alex.
Fuck off. What are you doing down here?
Come to get you, Alex. Come on.
Fuck off!
They're turning the lights off, Alex.
Don't need you to help me. I don't need anyone. I fucking quit. You can relax. We'll call it a draw.
I'm very sorry to hear that, Alex.
No, you're not. You've got what you always wanted. You got rid of the hurricane. You'll find out what it's like soon enough. Stephen Hendry will come along and knock you off your perch, and then you'll know what it's like. Why do you hate me?
Come on, I don't hate you. I've never hated you. I idolized you. When I watched you play, I thought it was genius. I wanted to be just like Alex Higgins. Once.
No, that's not true. We've always been enemies.
I'm not your enemy, Alex. You are. And the drink.
That's right, blame me. Everyone else does.
You look after yourself.
Remember this. I'll get the romantic obituaries when I die. And you can keep the fucking money. Good night.
You were born
on the
starlight, and all the angels singing, you just about got it right. Cut through with silver, goodness and heaven know. Don't know where we're going, darling. Yeah. gave so much freedom, but freedom is just another word. When you've no one left to hurt, I said, yeah.